Like to do that. I'm saying that's only on a scale of 1 to 10, that exercise is only a 4. Because I want to do what? I want to do it this way. I want, no, just face me. We want to go sideways. We want to go laterally. Why? Because we already said 80% of the game, they say 80%. How much is it? 80, 90, 95% is lateral. So let's do it laterally. How many think we can do it on the first try?
Yeah.
Good, half of you do. Ready? Go. Ready? Go.
Yeah.
So that's racquet quickness. Make sure you go lateral. Make sure you go lateral. Here we go. Next one. I need 8 people to form a circle right here. 8 people. Quick, 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 quick. You don't need your rackets. 8 people in a circle.
No racket.
No racket. No racket. Okay. So we got our 8 people. Forget your name. Brent, you're in the center. You're in the center. And so what is agility? Agility is doing what? Changing directions. There's nothing better than playing dodgeball to change directions. But here are our rules. Now, the rules are we're going to roll. Now, we don't know how to throw yet, but we're going to do our best we can. Now, the best thing is that everybody is going to be in their best ready position. You're going to catch it, and you're going to roll. And it must be a roll, and it has to hit Bryn below the knee. If you hit her, yes, thank you. If you hit her, you take your spot. So it looks just like this. We have our 8 people. Yeah. Ready? The only rule that I have, you have to change directions rather than jump.
Okay.
Because they jump, what's going to happen? They could come down on top of the ball, right? So that's pretty easy. So, Bryn, we're going to put a couple balls now here. Now we got to go. Stay there. You're in.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so circle dodgeball. How long will kids play that game?
Ever.
Can we play circle dodgeball? Yeah. So good. How cool are these balls?
Oh, they're the best.
They're the best, yeah. You got these from, are you familiar with Gopher Sports? Or what's the other big supply?
Gorilla.
Gorilla, yeah. So these are great because they don't hurt anybody, and we can use these. They're easy durable. To catch. They're durable. All right, so good stuff. All right, here we go. How are we doing? Another one you can do. Bryn, you're still back in the center.
Right?
No. Yeah. Is that your best effort?
Yeah.
All right. So we can do the same thing, but this time we're tossing, and all you need to do is touch it, right? Not as good as rolling, because you're always going to have people that just never give her a chance because they're going to toss the ball way too high. But you're just trying to touch it,
okay.
and go, right? And yeah. And if you hit it, they take their spot. You take their spot. Yeah, you're just trying to go over their head. Give them a chance, but don't. Yeah.
Well, I do this. If they miss it, then you go in.
No, if they can touch it. Okay. Good enough. Everybody over on the other side of the net. Here we go. We're over all over here. Really? We're going to do that?
15-year-old.
Yeah, right. So they start to get this attitude, right? So, yeah. So what can you do with an agility ladder? You can do a ton of stuff, and we're just going to demonstrate. So first thing is 2 in all the way through, right? Get your line in just 2 feet. You're jumping. Yeah, so both feet, right, both feet at the same time. Go. Yeah, you're just getting warmed up here, yeah. When you started it, okay. 1 foot, go. So you're hopping on 1 foot. What do you think's next? The other foot, right. The other foot, right, the other foot, which is probably your non-dominant foot. And you're gonna see some differences here.
Great job.
Yeah. Next one, takes the skill. You're gonna do a carioca. What's a carioca? You don't necessarily, and some people get just tripped up with a ladder, and I don't care about the ladder, but the carioca is doing what? It's here, uh-huh. So if you want to do it with a ladder, it's a challenge. But otherwise, you can just do that. How about two in, two out, two in, two out, all the way up? Two in, out, yep, that's it. Very good. Good. Lateral. So I like you can do lateral. Same things we did lateral. Let's do not only a lateral, but make sure that we're stopping and starting again. So I want to go here, 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 here. So it's two up, one back. Two up, one back. Okay? Go. And I'm not so hung up that they get the right sequence every time, right off the bat. As long as they're going from side to side and progressing up the ladder, that's a good thing.
I did that, but I did forward.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Two and back.
Yeah, right, right.
That lateral
right.
Is really good.
Yeah, it's, yeah. Uh-huh. Okay, without the ladder, the icky shuffle, remember that guy? Used to play for who? No, Stanford.
Cincinnati.
Cincinnati, right, he played for Cincinnati, and he'd score, big guy, right, big fullback, right? And he would score, and he'd do the icky shuffle. What was the icky shuffle, remember that one? Everybody, go, icky shuffle. All right, who wants a challenge? Carl, you want a challenge? You're going to do, with the agility ladder, you're going to do 180s all the way down. 180, 180, 180, 180. William can do it. How many think he can do it? That works for me. Yeah. I was going to go here. Yeah, but same thing. Yep. Works.
All right.
How are we doing?
Use before not use.
Very nice. Very nice. Got it?
Do you do it again?
That's it. Good. And you can, yeah. There you go. All right, so that takes care of agility. So we're moving right along. So we've done one thing. It took us 45 minutes, so we got to pick up the pace. So how many have their rackets? How many have rackets here? A few of you. if you have a racquet, grab a racquet, because we're going to do a couple of things and fun stuff with balls and rackets. Helvin, can I have mine, please? Thank you.
Five to three?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, we got about, yeah. Everybody gets one of these. These are fun. These are fun. It's too bad you don't have your rackets, because it's even more fun. So. It's all right. No. You know what those are, David? Well, you have one? All right. So, how many use these with little kids? These are unbelievable. Now, the thing is, and can you keep these? No, they are a good substitute for a ball, because you can do things with these when they rack it that you can't do with a ball to develop. And they are a substitute for what? A bean bag. But I can line up 100 kids and have 100 bean bags and have 100 koosh balls, and what's 100 kids going to go and get? One of these dudes, right? So they're fun, and you can do some fun things with them. So where'd my racket go? What kind of balance is this? Static. Static balance, because we're not moving. All right, easy, tough? Let's make it tougher, right? So everybody went down which way? With a foot and back. Put a leg out in front, and this time go down and touch the court, balancing that ball or that koosh ball on your racket. Okay, next several. If you have a racket, come on out here, because you can demonstrate, or just step out. We're going to do some fun things with balls and rackets. Alvin, can I have those balls? Can you roll that card up? Okay, here we go. So this time you're going to be balancing the koosh ball in your hand, and you're going to bounce one ball down on one foot. Very good. Bounce the ball up. Good, good, good. You're going to bounce both balls down.
Does it have to be a
Stanford
ball?
Okay. So you bounce, both of them down, right? You can stand on both feet. See if you can do both feet, because this is a tough one. Good. Can you bounce both of them up? Really hard. Really hard. I think you can do it. So you're doing, you're bouncing the ball up.
Like catching it?
Uh-huh. Yep. I think you can do it. He's got it. He's got it. He's going to use the koosh ball, right?
I'm trying to hit this up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very good. All right. Can you? We did that. Bouncing down, bouncing up, hopping. Good. So we get different variations, but doing those things, those are really a challenge. And they're not only balance, but a lot of coordination. What's coordination? Because we haven't defined what coordination is. What's coordination? Layman's terms, coordination is what? So we know agility is moving side to side. What's balance? We talked about balance too. We talked about balance? Yeah, we're talking about balance right now. What's balance? Everybody right here, so I don't have to yell at you. Quick, 5 seconds so I can see your eyes. What is balance? Somebody give me a definition of balance.
Being able to hold a position.
Position, right. So here's I used to define it with my elementary school kids, right? And balance is nothing more than a low center of gravity over a wide base. Where's your center of gravity? High and low, where is it? Belly button, right? So you tell that to a kid, Ross, I want you to put your belly button over a wide base. If your belly button gets outside of that base, what's happening? You're gonna fall over, right? So that means, and who is the lowest? David, who's the lowest? You've done all these studies on movement. Who is lower than anybody else on tour right now?
Serena gets pretty low.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Djokovic, unbelievable, right? He's way down here, so his balance is unbelievable as he's moving. He just he doesn't stumble. He doesn't. So his and if you watch, you get video of him. He's really down here. His thighs are parallel, right? So that's balance. Low center of gravity over a wide base. Where's your center of gravity? Belly button. So kids can identify with that. You need to keep your belly button over a wide base. That's why this is hard to keep a balance. That's why this is even harder to keep your balance, because your center of gravity is even higher. So you moved your belly button up higher. Right, so that's what balance is. Bouncing line stability. Okay, here's what I want you to do. Just wherever you are, I want you to find a line, and this is an easy one. I just want you to walk along the line. Go. See how good you are standing and staying on a line as you're walking. Yeah, well, yeah, you can walk just normally. All right, now what you need, the next thing you're going to do is everybody needs to find a partner, and you need one rag per partner or per team. One rag per team. Here we go. Oops, sorry, Brent. Here we go.
Return
these, or? Yeah. Got it? All right, here's what you're going to do. With your partner, you're going to walk along. So one person's walking. I got Ross walking a line. All right, we'll take your koosh ball. Right? And what I want you to do is, as you walk along this line, you're trying to stay on balance, and I'll be the demonstrator. So you're trying to stay on balance, and your partner is just trying to nudge you off balance. So she's going to be just tugging a little bit. Now, you're working with your partner, not against them, right? But just see how, so I'm doing pretty good here, but if somebody's kind of jostling me, it's going to really be more difficult for me to maintain my balance. I'm not trying to yank their arm out, but you can just see if they can.
Kids. Yep. Kids,
yep.
It's head and under kids.
Yeah, they'll do it, but you have to demonstrate it properly, right? So I'm walking, and you're not doing anything. There we go. So, yeah. All right. So you're just trying to give me a little bit of this. Uh-huh. All right. Go with your partner. Go. You demonstrate it, and you don't let them do it. You don't let them do it. You say it's a cooperative thing, and they're going to reverse it. But yeah.
Little girls will be.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Good. Okay, so you can take that same thing. You can take these and sometimes it's a little difficult because you get kids in this next one. It's a good one. They like to do it, but here's your warning. So you're going to do the same thing. You got your rag. You're going to hold on tight, and you're going to bounce. I know she can come on over here because I can't do this one. You're going to bounce on one foot. One foot, and you're going to try to pull your partner over that line. So it's a tug of war. Here's your warning. Kids don't have the grip strength. And so they're pulling, and then they let go because they don't have the grip strength. So you can go ahead, but hold on tight and see if you can, on one foot, you're hopping, see if you can pull the other person over. You can hop, 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 hop.
Oh, I can hop.
Yeah, right, yeah. And then, okay, so initially he wins. So we're going to put you on your opposite leg, opposite arm. Ah. Yeah, now let's see what happens. See if his opposite leg, opposite arm is a little stronger or weaker. Yeah. He's good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just let it go. All right. So the tug of war. Can you do a push of war? Yeah. Uh-huh. How do you do that one? Russ, you're my partner. All right. So we're pushing. We're pushing. And this time, yeah, we can be on 1 foot. But you're going to see if I can, if you can push me back so you can jump over this line.
Okay. Right. I'm not going to because there's a wall.
Yeah. There's not one. Yeah. So, right. Plus, I have no leg. So, so you can do that. Frog hops. We talked about that. We crossed the river. We did the frog hops. The monster walks. Monster walks. Good for balance. What's a monster walk? Sharon, you want to demonstrate a monster walk? Yes. So Sharon's got it. Our arms above your head. You're going to take a step. I want your thigh parallel with the ground. Good. Hold it. Now step ahead. Yeah. How good is that? Very good. Yeah. All right, Sharon, another variation. I want you to take a step, hold it, 3 steps, hold it. So you've got a couple of quick steps in between. Good. With the other foot. That's it. Yeah, okay, good. Red light, green light. You need your rackets. You need your rackets, but I like to use koosh balls on this one. What is that one? It's a balanced one. It's a good for agility. You've got your racket, you're balancing, and you've got the coach in front calling out red light, green light. What are you doing? You're running, and then when you get red light, you have to stop and not lose your balance, nor lose the ball. I like to start out with a koosh ball. Kids like to do that with a koosh ball. They like to do that sort of thing. Everybody on the sideline, put your toes on the single sideline. Toes on your single sideline, quickly. And everybody on this side of the court, because we're going to be everybody over here. I want you up on your toes, and I want you to walk forward without touching your heels. Go. And back, but this time you're using only your heels. You can't touch your toes as you're moving sideline to sideline. Go. Time's up, yeah, almost, yep.